Comisionado por el gobierno ecuatoriano a finales de los años 40, Guayasamín crea la obra Huacañán, El Camino del Llanto, The Way of Tears, en 1952. El mural Ecuador hace parte de esta obra junto a 103 cuadros y 3 retratos. Los 103 cuadros se dividen en 3 grupos temáticos: indios, mestizos y negros. Cada tema está asociado con un paisaje ecuatoriano: la montaña con los indios, Quito con los mestizos y la selva con los negros. Los 3 retratos son de José Miguel Guayasamín, su padre, de Benjamín Carrión, el director de la Casa de la Cultura Ecuatoriana y mecenas de Guayasamín, y un hermoso autorretrato. El mural Ecuador combina los 3 temas étnicos y está compuesto por 5 paneles móviles.
During the first half of the 20th century, Ecuador was a distressed and fragmented nation. In the early 1940s, after a war in which Ecuador lost nearly half of its territory to Peru, Ecuador faced major economic and political problems, a profound crisis of identity, and numerous challenges such as continuous political unrest, protests by the indigenous and peasants' populations, a discriminatory society, illiteracy, and economic underdevelopment. Since the mid-1940s, a series of modernizing liberal policies were implemented to address the challenge of building a modern nation, a stable economy, and a cohesive sense of national culture. Hoping to organize and solidify the Ecuadorian nation, President José María Velasco Ibarra first, and then Galo Plaza Lasso, introduced and implemented a series of initiatives from 1944 through 1952. For example, literacy campaigns were begun, participation of indigenous people in the economic market was promoted, and the first national census was conducted in 1950 to establish a better understanding of who were the Ecuadorians. Ironically, in a country with large indigenous and black populations, such as Ecuador, the first census of 1950 did not recognize or measure any racial differences.
El presidente Plaza Lasso promovió políticas de higiene, educación, cultura, y realizó el primer censo nacional de 1950. Con estas políticas se anunciaba la entrada de Ecuador a la modernidad, una modernidad sin razas, la modernidad mestiza. El censo de 1950 no utilizó categorías raciales. La nación ecuatoriana fue definida con la categoría de mestizo. Se pensaba que las categorías raciales estaban relacionadas con el racismo y que afectaban la unidad nacional.
A classic definition of identity from the Enlightenment period is in essence individualistic. A person is a fully centered, unified individual endowed with the capacities of reason, consciousness, and action, whose center consisted of an inner core. This Enlightenment perspective assumes that this inner core comprises a person's identity and is present from birth, remaining substantially the same throughout a person's life. Unlike the Enlightenment definition of identity as self-sufficient, more recently, sociology suggests that identities cannot stand on their own. They are formed by the interaction of the self and society, connecting the personal inner core with the public, our interactions with others, and in doing so, create a dynamic relationship between our own personal identities and the outside world. One's inner core is formed and modified by its interactions with the cultural world outside. Given that we live in a globalized context, society today is part of a world without borders. Our own identities cannot be expected to remain closed off per the individualistic definitions of the Enlightenment or the stable internal-external relationship of sociology. Our identities cannot adhere to one master identity. We all assume different identities at different times, all of which are not unified by a singular notion of the self. Given the vast possibilities of the world around us, we are also confronted with a fleeting multiplicity of possible identities. Our identities and our ability to identify with others is, at a basic level, a public presentation acted out before an ever-changing audience, from intimate to public, from friends and families to colleagues, teachers, and strangers. Who we are exists within a constant state of motion and negotiations. We are not static, but should be interpreted more as dynamic puzzles of images that are constantly shifting.
Osvaldo Guayasamín, one of the greatest Latin American artists of the 20th century, was honored with numerous prizes from the Barcelona, Sao Paulo, and Mexico biennials, the French Legion of Honor, and recognized by UNESCO with its José Martí Prize. His art has been shown in museums across the Americas and Europe. the Museo de Bellas Artes in Mexico, the Museo de Arte Contemporáneo de Madrid, the Musée d'Art Moderne de la Ville de Paris, the Petit Palais in Paris. Guayasamin is known for his bold paintings, murals, and sculptures. To fully understand his art, we must understand the man. The themes of Guayasamin's art intertwine with his life and the socio-political context in which he lived. Osvaldo Guayasamin was a native son of Ecuador, an Andean country bordering Colombia and Peru, facing the Pacific Ocean. He was born in Quito, Ecuador, on July 6, 1919, the eldest of 10 siblings. Growing up, he experienced economic hardship and a difficult and violent relationship with his father. Despite these shortcomings, Guayasamin was able to pursue art, aided by his mother's unconditional support. Those early memories of maternal love left a mark on Guayasamin and ultimately became a recurring theme in his work. Life in Ecuador provided other hardships for Guayasamin, along with all who shared his indigenous heritage. Because of his skin color, he suffered racial discrimination in a society largely defined by the colonial legacy of prejudice and inequality. Reacting to injustices experienced, Guayasamin became an outspoken Marxist, sympathizing with revolutionary and insurgent movements in Latin America and adamantly opposing imperialism and foreign interventions. Although a man of humble origins, he became a rich, well-respected artist and a friend of powerful dignitaries and celebrities. His family knew him as a tender father, but also a difficult man. A major turning point for Guayasamin occurred at an exhibition he held in the city of Guayaquil, Ecuador, in 1942. The exhibition caught the eye of Nelson Rockefeller, then head of the U.S. State Department Office of Inter-American Affairs. Rockefeller, who purchased five of Guayasamin's paintings, arranged for the artist to receive a government grant to tour the United States with his art for 7 months. This tour marked the beginning of Guayasamin's international career and soon brought him worldwide acclaim. After his U.S. tour, Guayasamin traveled to Mexico in 1943 and met the great muralist José Clemente Orozco. Orozco was part of a larger movement of Mexican muralists, which included Diego Rivera and David Alfaro Siqueiros, who generally worked within the nationalist ideology of the Mexican Revolution, though the subjects of their artwork differed. Muralism, with its emphasis on public art and the use of national themes, inspired Guayasamin. The mural titled Ecuador vividly presents the divisive antagonism of the three ethnic themes in a series of five movable panels. The panel's interchangeability displays multiple possibilities to envision the nation, highlighting the fluidity of the concept of identity. Originally, Guayasamin calculated, or rather miscalculated, a total of 150 possible mural arrangements. However, if we consider the mural in rectangular configurations, we have 30,720 possibilities.
By using violent brush strokes and by depicting disquieting human bodies, Guayasamin's Huacañán reminds us that the process of nation formation is anything but harmonious, and that nation itself is a work in progress, a restless series of contradictions and continuous negotiation of differences. Perhaps that is the reason the mural Ecuador is so central to this collection. It physically reenacts this restlessness. The movable mural shows that creating a nation, the Ecuadorian nation, entails countless possible combinations, that the nation deals with difference instead of wholeness, and that contradiction should not be erased or resolved, but embraced as a fundamental component of any country.
Hoy, el mural Ecuador está enmarcado y expuesto en el Museo Capilla del Hombre en la ciudad de Quito. El marco inmoviliza el mural, no permite recombinarlo. Buen pintor y malo en matemáticas, Guayasamin calculó solamente 150 posibilidades de combinación del mural. Hoy sabemos que el mural Ecuador tiene numerosísimas posibilidades y combinaciones que el artista no calculó. El mural Ecuador no muestra un espacio de mezcla armónica, no muestra la Nación Unida o mestiza. El mural muestra fragmentos y conflictos que no pueden ni deben ser enmarcados. En el 2013 se crea el grupo de investigación Ecuador Unframed, Dynamic Art and Radical Democracy in a Mural by Osvaldo Guayasamin, dirigido por el profesor Carlos Jauregui y respaldado por la Fundación Guayasamín y el Kellogg Institute. Mediante una reinstalación dinámica y a través de un programa multimedia, el mural es liberado de su marco y podemos tener la experiencia de sus múltiples posibilidades de combinación. Este programa permite que las imágenes de los paneles se proyecten en una pantalla. Las imágenes que se proyectan están constantemente en movimiento y pueden también ser combinadas por el público de manera interactiva. Ecuadorian Frame permite pensar la nación y la identidad nacional como una serie de instalaciones temporales en constante cambio, donde la negociación de los conflictos es más importante que la supuesta armonía nacional. El conflicto y el cambio son importantes en el arte, lo mismo que en la política. Así, el mural Ecuador entra en diálogo con los desafíos que enfrenta un Estado para constituirse a través de la diferencia y la diversidad. El mural móvil fue diseñado como un dispositivo sincrético, un artefacto que combina y recombina las diferencias. En el 2014 nace el proyecto Art in Motion, que permitirá a un público amplio el acceso a la obra de Guayasamín y a la exhibición dinámica. Art in Motion organiza actividades pedagógicas relacionadas con la experiencia indígena, identidad, derechos humanos, opresión, política, violencia, paz, desigualdad, diferencia, razas y democracia. Estas actividades se realizarán en diferentes universidades de Estados Unidos y en otros países. La instalación dinámica del mural Ecuador será exhibida permanentemente en la Fundación Guayasamín. Nosotros queremos que los visitantes desenmarquen Ecuador y pongan el arte en movimiento. We hope to inspire visitors to unframe Ecuador and to put art in motion.
Quiero que a mí me entierre como a mis antepasados. Yo quiero que a mí me entierre como a mis antepasados. En el vientre oscuro y fresco de una vasija de luz.